Hello Woolly Clubbers, we're on the last part of our pencil case now, just to show you. Oops, suppose I pinned it on, I forgot I pinned it on. There's the pencil case, we've put our end on, I filled my hole in. Okay, and that's the point of it. Okay, and now we're going to attach the sip. So I've got it the right way, with the V shape, with these, and that's the inside, the bubbly bit. That's if you've done knit and purl. If you've done knit all the way through, it'll still be bobbly all the way through. Now, I'm gonna add my zip. You can either add it so it opens that end, or you can turn it around and add it. That end, it's entirely up to you what you want to do, but I wanna do it this end because I know I'm gonna have to stitch a bit of that end up, and it'd be easier if I sewed it from that end. So we have got to, right way around, have the pulley bit on the outside. Okay, so make sure that's on the outside, and you are going to, with some little pins, okay, you're going to pin it in place. Now make sure that silver bit is tucked right up close to there, so there's no gap, right, because you're going to stitch it in there. If I turn it inside out, you will stitch that, I'll just show you, like that, to there, you'll stitch it, okay. So inside out, that's the right way, okay, so you're just going to pin it. You'll see, because you'll see it on how it looks, you know how it looks. So just pin it there. Okay, leave your sip open, don't do it up, because once you've sewn it, it's easier to do. Okay, and then all along the edge here, you are going to pin the sip in place. This is that knit bit you've done. So you're just going to pin it all the way along there. You can do the pins on the outside or inside, it's up to you. I'm just doing it on the inside to show you. All the way along. Some more pins there. And again, all the way along. Sorry, keep forgetting the camera's lower than, so it should look like that. Pin all the way along, and do the other side as well. This is, we're just going to sew it all in place. Get another pin, and do it all the way along. Your knitted 2 stitches edge. Keep going all the way. Another pin. So that it is, when you pull it together, you've got your zip in place. Okay, we will have to sew this bit up at the end. Alright, that's why I left it till the end, because that bit's there. Alright, okay, so now we need our needle. You need your sewing needle, not the big eyed one, the big yarn one, yarn needle like this. That's the yarn needle, that's the sewing needle. Can you see? Okay. So you need your sewing needle, open your zip again, and turn it inside out. So turn it inside out, so the zip's on the inside. And I'm just going to start at this end, okay? I'm going to start here at this end. First of all, I'm going to make a little knot. Come on, why are you not going through? That's it. Now you can do the loop, like I showed you with the wall, or you can just do a little, another stitch, just to make a loop. Like I showed you when you're fastening off, you're doing the same thing with starting. It just gives it that extra bit of strength. even though it had a knot on the end. Oh, I've got riddle. Let's see. Right. Okay, so I'm ready to start sewing all the way down that bit, the zip. Okay, little stitches, little running stitches you can do. Okay, tiny little stitches. Oops, daisy. Tiny little stitches all the way along. Now I like to do, I'll show you with pen and paper. I like to go down here and come up here. So my needle's gone down and comes up here, okay? Then I go back down in between there and come back up here. And you keep going, doing that all the way along. Go down between, come up. Between, go down, up, down, up, down. So you're going back on yourself all the time. Okay, you don't have to do that. A normal running stitch will work. But this stitch is just a little bit stronger than a running stitch. So, and because you can't see, because I've got a purple and black cotton, you're not going to really see it. So you just, oops. And all the way through, and where I have come out there, I'm going to go back a bit, go down, and then go up again. And you, as you go along, you can pull your needle, your pins out. Be careful though, they do prick into you. And you just do that, oops, all the way along. Oh dear, oh dear, I'm getting in the right state here. You'll have more time than me, so you'll be able to take your time to do it. And then down again. And then up again. Just want to make sure I'm definitely catching. I am definitely catching. It's catching where we need the pins. Okay, and you keep going until you have sewn all of the zip in place, making sure that you are catching the wall the other side. Otherwise, it won't be attached to it. Okay, you'll be just sewing the zip. So again, down, up. I have a knot in my cotton. And then down, go back a bit, come up. Okay, and then go down and up all the way to the end. Knot it off and then do the other side. Okay, when you've done that, we'll go on to the next step. All right, catch you in a minute.